Welcome to FMTraining.tv. My name is Margaret. I'll be your broadcast engineer for today. I'm here with the wonderful Nick Hunter. Hey, Nick, how you doing?
Hello, I'm doing good and yourself?
Pretty good, thank you. All right, so today we're continuing our FM Go mini series. We are doing day 7 and day 8 for this. Today is Tuesday, tomorrow is Wednesday. If you'd like to support the channel, we'd greatly appreciate it. We do talk about this 5 days a week. We talk about a variety of topics. We this week and next week are, well, this whole week and the beginning of next week are all very FileMaker mobile themed. We do talk about a wide variety. Pretty much, we talk about Pro, Server, Go, all that jazz. We discuss it. But people, every once in a while, I'll have someone pop up in my chat that goes like, "Hey, I really don't like the live stream format. I'm looking for very specific answers, or I don't like the conversational like approach you guys have, because we tend to take questions mid-flight, as Richard would like to call it, as a basically, to keep the questions on topic. Otherwise, we tend to collect questions all at the very end, and a lot of people say, "Well, what is this?" without clarifying what this is. As a result, we can't answer their question. It's much easier to just tackle it as we go along. And it also fosters a community that we like. But if you don't like any of that, which is understandable, sometimes you're just here to get an answer to a question, feel free to pick up one of our bundles. If you've bought it, thank you very much. If not, you should give it a look. Okay. I think we're good now. All right, Nick, what are we doing today?
Hello. Okay, so what do we do today? So thank you guys for joining today. And so what we do, we continue talking about iOS and especially for iPhone. So everything that I said so far for the iPhone is valid for the iPad. The iPad, the difference will be the real estate, right? So that's why everything I'm talking right now, I'm building the layout for the iPhone, and then we're going to build the layout for the iPad. Okay, so out of the iPhone layout, we will do the iPad layout, right? Which will be quite the same, but with some differences. So, but mostly of the code will be reusable. It's just a real estate reconfiguration, but it's not coding. The coding will be the same. So today we continue talking about this, and so yesterday. We talk about how to do make a selection, right? A multiple selection on iOS to be iOS-y, okay? To look and feel native, to look and feel something that works, 100% on the iPhone or the iPad. And because we don't want to mock up something that is not real, right? Sometimes we can do things that look real. Right, but when we cannot do something that looks and behave real, you don't want to do that. It will be a failure because people will feel like something wrong, right? With the way I did the multi-selection like yesterday, you cannot feel it that it's not a native object, right? It feels completely native. So and behave and simple, quite simple. Just you have to come to get the concept of a build up a list in the variable and then rely exclusively on the variable and not trying to select fields and stuff like this. So I want to jump into this and continue things that we were talking about yesterday. So why we can't do a selection so using a field is because let's say I have a field, I have a tag field, right? That means you can tag it, and so if you do that, right, let's assume you work on an app that is shared on the server, right? So what will happen if you have a field like this, right? Let's put that here, like this, right? And you have a checkbox, for example. Even though you remember I told you the checkbox, it is not at all an iOS object, neither is radio button, right? But let's say you have a checkbox and you do this. and you do this, right? So you see how, even though, it's slow because I'm doing Zoom stuff, but even though, look the time of the response. I click, it's not instant, right? So just for a checkbox. And the problem is you modify this record and you put a one here. You set the record, you set the field tag for that record with one. That means if this layout is shared on many other screens, many other clients, well, everybody will see your selection. And somebody can say, no, I don't want it. And just unclick it if you want to unclick it. Right? And you say, no, I want it. And another guy on the network say, I don't want it. Yes, but I want it. No, I don't want it. That's what will happen because all of this will be shown. And if you do this after that, what you need to do a replace, or to clean those. It's slow, it's sluggish, it doesn't work. It's trash. No, we don't want that. Right? So that's why you need to work exclusively on a variable, because the variable exists only on your session, only on your clients, right? And the advantage is like it's like super fast because you're not modifying, you're not opening records, you're not commenting records, you're not doing all of those things, right? And to clear is super fast as well because you just have to what's the name? Set a variable blank, right? So, when you click here, the response is so fast compared to the field, right? So do we have any question from yesterday that people didn't, we didn't answer?
I believe we're good, actually. So.
Okay. So now, the thing I want to talk today is the search. Search on an iPad or an iPhone, right? So get any app you have on your phone. Open any app with a search capabilities and look how it is. And don't look further. Look on your phone and look the search, the main search, So what you see, if you want to search on your phone, right? You drag down, you swap down the finger, right? And what do you have? You have one field where you put whatever you want there. So this is how we search on the phone. I'm not talking about specific search. I'm talking about global search, like quick finds, something like this, right? And pretty much is what we're going to use, right? I want to see, I'm here, right? And I want to search on pretty much what I'm seeing here, right? But maybe I want to add other thing because or before to talk about the search, maybe I can talk about something else that I forgot. Sorry for that. I'll talk about search later. But on the phone, we are on the phone here, right? So this is a list on the phone, right? So I don't have a lot of record here, but let's add other contacts here. So let's add right just for the demo. So Scott Kane. Let's put her. Let's put the category and the title. Maybe I will do the salt today and I will do the salt today and the search later. I changed my mind. It's the same though. And let's put another one. Let's put our. I think you have. I don't know if it's coming. It's coming here, David Angel. Don't know. Long time we didn't see it. Right.
It's here. Yep.
Oh, he's there. Okay.
Yes.
Who else we have online?
Foxy Jack.
Okay. I have some people here, so I have a better. Okay. And here, what I want to do, right? I want to get this sorted. Okay. So I'm going to get this sorted by name four. But when you have a list like this, so by name four, you know, but when you have a list like this, you know, David Angel, Foxy Jack, Joe, you know, Nick Hunter, like this, right? And I want to sort this, right? But normally, so I don't know how they do on the on the Mac. I don't remember on the phone, how the contact list is sorted. Yeah, it's sorted like this. It's sorted by the first name and you know. Okay, so it's sorted, but something is missing, right? And what is missing, because that the advantage to be on list view, you know, is because I can add a part on the you know, on the layout, and I can add a part like this. It's a subsummary sort when full name, or name full. Okay. And above. So here now I have a subsummary sort by. Okay. And here I'm going to put this, the initial unique. Okay. So typically, we do that black and no background, and we put that 16. Right? Like this. Like this. Okay. And we put that here. Like this. So now, this is how it looks like. Right? So unfortunately, I don't have, but I should have the initial for the first name. So let's put the initial. Let's put an initial that will build the initial. So let's duplicate this and call this phone or mobile, because I want an initial that, if I have both first name, yeah, this is what it's doing. This is what he's doing, but I want to invert, I want to reverse this, right? So this is how you do an initial. That means I have a first name, last name. This is the first letter for the initial for the first, initial for the last, right? I put that uppercase to make sure that the initial always appears capital. And then I want the left, the first character of those two combined. So let's say I have Nick Hunter here. So that will be NH, and that will be NH, and that will return, right? So let's do it. Oh, I cancel like an idiot. Init last. Init first and last. Okay, so let's not cancel that time. So this is technique that are cool to know, cool to learn, to use instead of doing like if is empty, wow. You know, if it's not empty, then the first name, then you know, stuff like this. You know, it's a mess. So that's why I like to show you working like this. So let's say, so the first name here is Foxy Jack, right? So if I combine those two, right? If I combine those two, I have this G, I don't know where I am. Oh, Johan, I'm here, right? Johan. So this is Joe, this is Han. And this is the first J, and this is the last H. So that means I combine both like this, and I'm getting only the first character on the left of both. That means if I rem if this one is blank, if this one is blank, I have H. Right? If this one is blank, I have J. Right? Because the first is there. You understand what I mean? So if both blank, of course, but if I have only the last, I have H. If I have both, I have J. And if this one blank, I have J two because this one we don't care because he's taking the left of both characters. So we don't need if is empty last name, then take the first letter of the first name. Otherwise, all those cases stuff crazy, right? So that is a good technique to use to get stuff like this. So now I'm going to change this to the initial unique, to the initial mobile, which is currently empty. But, let's get this. Yeah, I need to put, let's put the first name here. Name first. So to initiate this, so to reset or auto entry, we involve many fields. Just select one field involved in the calculation and replace it by itself. Name first. So you replace by itself. That will trigger the auto entry and gets the thing done. Boom. So now I have D, F, J, N, R, right? So if I do a sort again, I need to sort by first name, last name, not full name, first and last. And this will initiate this. Why is it not coming? Oh, yeah, I need to do this. Name first. Why is it not combining both here? I should, it should. Put together. Why is not doing this? Subsummary by full, by name first. Okay, let's say remove the last. Why is not doing this? Oh, sorry, my bad. So yeah, my bad. I can do full, but I need to search to sort by the initial mobile. And this need to be sold by initial mobile as well. So, yeah. So now the two R are grouped together. So you know what I mean. So we have a sort with a grouping by first name, by initial. The R together, the And if I have another N, so let's create another N. I don't know, or Nicholas, I don't know, blah. So automatically it gets sorted. It get grouped, together. I have the ends and the R with the initial here, right? So this is cool. But let's say I want another sort system, right? So I want to be able to sort by type, right? I want to be able to sort by company, right? I want to sort by stuff like this. I want to say, I want to search by, the officer, manager. I want to sort by this, right? And I want to sort by this. So by title and by accounts, okay? I mean, that's not title. This is, yeah, title. Title and accounts, right? So I want to sort by name, so alphabetically, by title and this, right? So to do this, the best way is to have a key to put the sort keys, right? So this is the sort keys. It's a global field, right? And here we're going to put, oh, we had the sort. Yeah, this is another thing. So we have the sort key here, right? And I'm going to put that. So I'm going to show you the right way to do this, right? We don't want to use triggers and fields and pop-up menu and stuff like this. It is not good, right? It is not. But in the same time, I do want, right, to have something great to do the sort, right? So I will do the right way. So I'm going to do or I'm going to cl click here, right? And here I'm going to have a sort button. So you can go online and find a nice sort, but we can use the FileMaker sort icon that they have here. And if they want to raise me. Okay, so we have an icon here. Let me see if we have a custom icon that could be nice for sorting. No, we don't. So let's use the FileMaker or sort icon, which is this one. Okay. So I have a sort icon here, right? And oh, but this is a popover. Needs to be a popover. So there's two ways. What do I do? I use a popover, or do I use? No, I don't use a popover. Let's do the right way. Okay. So when you sort like this, right? You want to use the right way to sort this, right? So you build a layout. So I can duplicate this contact card here, and I'm going to build a layout for the sorting. Okay. And this is sort card. We don't care the table. Let's use the same table as the original. So that's a sort card. Okay, so let's open this layout, right? So my default layout, right? The width of the layout is 365. So let's put that in 365. Let's put this the blank. The white background, right? And let's put it like this. And this will be the sort panel, let's say. Will be a sort panel. So we have three buttons here. Sort by name, right? And let's put, I don't know if we have an alternate. Okay, we don't. So I'm going to build the alternate button that I want. I want the blank background. I want a blue and a blue here. Right? Hover state, we don't care. But when I press it, I want the opposites to happen. So, you know, so I want when I it appears like this, but when I press it, it appears like this. Okay. I want a strong like way to see that I tap this. Okay. Then we have by title. Okay. And we have by you know, by account. So this is a single step. Yeah, it's not a single step. You need to be a you need to be a what's the name? You need to be a script, okay? Because this needs to disappear. Right, the when you sort, this window needs to go away, okay? But I have a technique for to have one unique script, right, to sort. So we create a script like this. This is sort contacts, and we need to send to that script a parameter. So here, you set a variable and you say, this is a sort key. And the sort key is the get script parameter, right? Because I'm going to use that sort key a lot. Okay, I mean, often, you know, three times. If sort key equal, okay, here I like to say 1, 2, 3. Right? I show you why. If it's equal one, you sort the record by initial, mobile, and name full. Now, else if sort key equal two, right? You duplicate this. And you say title. And if the key is free, account name. When you did, but before what you need to do, you close the window. Okay. Now here, you're going to send the scripts, use the scripts, sort, right, sort contact. This is one. This is sort contacts two. And this is sort contact three. You know, so it's easier to distinguish which one you want to do. So if the script parameter we set one, is set this one, two, this one, three, this one, and you can add as many you want. Right? So here, this button here will be a very, very single, a simple single script step, which you, in a new window. Okay. And this new window, right? It's a Kalthar window using my new sort card. I don't want this, and I don't want this. Of course, here, right? we need here and say cancel. And the cancel button, right, will be a single step close window. Correct? Or we can say close, right? We can say close. So this here is a new window car style. And the weight and the height and the width will be driven automatically by the height and the width of the layouts. 281, 365, automatically, since I'm using in the new window, I'm using these layouts, automatically said, okay, it's 281, 365. You can modify it, but by default, that will be. So now the distance from the top. I want this window to appear on the bottom of the screen, on the very bottom. Right? So pretty much what I want when I'm here, I want this window to appear on the bottom here. I want the window to fill this here, right? This is what I want. So it's very simple to do that. I know the height is 281. So the distance from the top, right, is the get window content height, right, minus 281. And the left, I don't care. So let's see how it behaves. Boom. It happened here, right? Knowing though, and it's unfortunate that my phone is doesn't work. I'm sorry for that, but on the phone, when you have something like that happening, a car style window, if you tap outside of the window, if you tap here, okay, that goes away. It closed the window. I know that it's a super cool behavior that only happened, but I need to have the closed window. So the closed window, this button here, this option will allow you to dismiss the window by tapping outside. So you won't have a close. Here I have a close button. On an iPhone, I won't have it. You tap outside, that dismiss the window, and you have the close window here. So that's good to know because I can do this, and if I don't care about this, I tap outside and that goes away. I know I wish we could have this on on the Mac, right? Or on on the computer. I wish, but we don't. I have no idea why they don't do that. You click outside and boom, it closes the window. So we have a closed window. We have a close button, right? But also we can sort by name, or we can sort by title, or we can sort by accounts. Correct? But now that I have a very nice native looking behaving, you know, sort, right? Correct? This sort, right? Right? And to be fair, I will have put this here. Okay. I will have put this here with a disappearance or with this, you know. I will have put this. So here we have this group of buttons here, we have those buttons here, you know. This but those all those buttons here. So this will have its own behavior, right? So I want this button here to go the way when this is there, but I want to include this to that group, right? Because I want this button to be a part of the refresh process. So you're in group. So, I showed you last time. You ungroup, you don't touch anything, you shift, you strike shift on your keyboard, you add the object, you regroup, and you put back the name. So now I have a sort button on the bottom, like this, but it goes away when I am selecting something, right? Yeah, I need to do that. To make the window adapt itself, I need to the width need to be adaptive. So to adapt the width of the window, you said this, get window content width. So that means now, if I have a bigger iPhone, because we don't know which iPhone, it could be a small iPhone, a bigger iPhone, but so when you type here, the window is big like this. And of course, we need to make that centered with these anchors to make this looking like this. So now this window is adaptive, right? Adapt itself. Correct? So now I have this sort by name, sort by title, and sort by account. But I want to do something cool here. This is when I sort by name, right? Or initial. And I want to add another part. I want the subsummary sort by title in both. And I want the subsummary sort by account name above. They're all 39. We can put 40 to be. They're all 40. In eighth, the parts. So, and I can duplicate this, put it here. Right? And put it here. And this will be title. So I can put the three a little bit bigger like this. And this will be the account name. So now I have this. This is RCC. This is no, right? So if I said by title, manager, officer, president, supervisor, right? Of course, I can remove those bars, which are totally, completely useless. Okay. So by name, I have the initial. By title, I have the is grouped by title. And by account, is grouped by account. So why is doing this? Because this behavior here follow the sorting, right? So when it's sorted by this, it shows this. But since it's not sorted by title and it's not sorted by account name, this won't show up. If I sort by title, it's not sorted by initial, so it will, and it's not sorted by account name, so it will show this and this will not show up. So that was the list view. Is cool much more than any pole you can put there, because you have this behavior, right? Really, if you look, if you see something like this on your hand, you can't say this is file maker, right? I mean, if you see that something like this on your phone, well, you have a button, you have this, sold by accounts, sold by title, sold by name. I will personally add another feature here, go to record first, because it's cool to always, when you sort, to go back to the first record on the phone, right? So you go to the first record, first record, first record. So you always land on the first record. I like this behavior. Then landing in the record you are in, right? Because this is a very filmmaker-ish behavior, and we want a phone behavior. A phone behavior, when you change status of their current state, when you change something, you need to go to the point, to the starting point of that state. So that means when you sort, that means you modify the state. Then when you modify the state at the end, you need to reinitialize and go back to mom and go back to the start, to square one. You cannot be in the middle of the list, right? So this is a rule on, on the mobile app. When you change a state of something visual, you need to come back to the original starting point. Do we have any question?
Not at the moment. I assume people are following along. Questions, comments, concerns, everyone? You're explaining it pretty cohesively, so. Think we're
Yeah,
good.
I'm getting better at explaining stuff.
I mean, you've been doing this for forever, Nick, so.
Yeah, this since 2016, by the way.
Yeah, a long time. So, I think we're good.
Okay. So why I put that on the bottom is because, well, the top here is a prominent axis, right? So the bottom is where you put stuff like this most of the time, not the top, Or when you have a lot of options, you don't fill this with buttons. When you have more than three, right? Then you need to have a menu, like a gear or some sort. And then inside you have something like this, and you have your options inside this, but you don't fill. You don't feel the bottom with buttons, right? So I don't know. It's an app that I'm using a lot. Do that. Named WhatsApp. So you have, when you want to do something like this, you and so you have option on the bottom, right? So and you have a menu. So most of the time you have a like a you have like a gear or something like this, or three dots, right? You have a kebab or something like this, a meatball. We call meatball the three dots, right? So the dot 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 like this, the icon like this, right? So but here it's okay. I don't have lots. But you separate, you separate what brings you somewhere else. So let me explain. This is on the phone. This is a very big rule. Okay. This, I stay there. I stay here. I stay, I stay in that layout. I'm not going anywhere. So they go, they are on the bottom. I'm staying there. This is local. This is there. This, no. It's a prominent main action that leads you somewhere else. Right? So most of the time on the top, you have plus button, you have launch a call, you have send email, you have things like this there on the top. When you need to change, when this will land you somewhere else. This, no, this is local actions, action that I'm doing here in that screen, right? Okay, so this is a rule on the phone, right? No, I'm not saying that apply to, oops, my screen. I'm not saying that that apply to all of the are on the computer, right? But on the phone, yes. On the mobile, yes. This leads you somewhere else, right? And this stays there. But you understand now that when you see something like this, you are seeing things like this everywhere, right? What you don't see, it's a pop-up menu. Like we are when what we have on the desktop, we don't, right? You don't sort with a pop-up menu. Show me an app where you sort with a pop-up menu. If you have an app that you sort with a pop-up menu, it's a piece of bleep. Send an email to the developer, say, hey, what the frick is this, right? It's not the standard. We don't have pop-up menus. Pretty much on the phone, if I may, on the phone or on the mobile general, all of this you can ignore it. Pretty much. Only, yeah, I mean, no, sorry. You can ignore when it comes to navigation. Changing filters, sorting options, stuff like this. I'm not saying that when you want to edit stuff like fields, right? Right? So if you want here, you can use a pop-up menu. I have one here. We can use a pop-up menu. There's no problem. FileMaker will handle this. But you don't use this to set a sort order, for example, right? To select a sort. No, it need to be like this. Don't use triggers on a field, something like this, right? So, do we have any questions?
Not at the moment. This is actually very cool, though. Yeah, people are saying that it looks good.
It looks no. I mean, if you show that to somebody, well, it won't look like oh my gosh, what that,
Yeah, but I mean, you know what you're looking at.
yes, right. So well, since yesterday I stayed like half an hour more. I think I'm good. I don't want to start something here because if I'm starting something, we go another half an hour over.
I think we're good. No,
Yeah.
thank you, Nick. Today was awesome.
So, yes, go ahead.
I'm just telling you, today was awesome. It's honestly really interesting, especially since I've been building mobile apps a lot more myself recently, and they do not, the UI for them is a disaster. So always good to learn from the master of such things.
Okay.
Thank you everyone for coming. Nick, I will see you tomorrow, right? Yeah, because tomorrow's Wednesday. So.
Yeah, tomorrow. Okay. So see you then there.
Yep, have a good one, everybody. We will see you later. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.